Starting just really simply, as I do most classes, we're going to start with a foot warm-up exercise today. So we're just really working on stretching through our arch. So I'm going to be starting with my right foot. You can pick to mirror me and start with your left or start with your right, up to you. But we're going up to the right toe, rolling the foot over to stretch the top of the foot, back down to that toe, feeling the arch, heel down. We're going to do that three more times on this side. So up to the toe, rolling the foot over, back to the toe, heel down, toe, rolling over, back to the toe, heel down, feeling that toe one more time, rolling over, back to the toe, and heel down. Let's repeat that to the other side. So up to that toe, rolling your foot over, back to the toe, heel down, to the toe, roll over, toe, heel down, toe, roll over, toe, heel down, last one, to the toe, rolling the foot over, back to the toe, heel down, and just kind of shake your feet out for a second.
And I am now making chat accessible to everyone. No one can unmute themselves. And okay,
so going from here, let's start with some isolation. So we're gonna work through the different parts of the body. I want to have you just really think about keeping as much stillness through your non-working body parts as you can throughout this set of exercises. I'm going to put on music and we're just going to start and I'll guide you through it. Six, seven, eight, starting with center.
But if you talk enough sense, then you'll lose your mind.
Back. Center.
The eyes is a focal point.
Center, last one.
So I don't lose sight of what I want.
Center.
And I feel
center, side. Center.
I miss
side.
You,
center, side.
And if you talk enough sense, then you'll lose
side.
Your mind.
Center, tip your
head. I love when it wasn't supposed to be. Right in front of me, talk some sense to me. And I found love where it wasn't supposed to be. Right in front of me, talk some sense to me.
Make a circle with your head. The other way.
I use you as a makeshift game.
Rolling just your shoulders around.
I use you as a rolling sign.
And back quadruply stop.
But if you talk enough sense, then you
keep rolling back. Good, and then put your hands on your ribs. We're going to think about sliding side, center, side, center, side, center, side, center, and front, center, back, center, front, center, back, center. Make a circle with just your ribs, keeping your hips still moving around. Another way. Good. Switch your legs like that. Alright, and we're thinking about just our hips now, so trying to keep your shoulders very still. We're going to think of going right, center, left, center. Keep your knees slightly bent. Center, left, center, right, center, left, center, and right, center, left, center. Now think of tipping your pelvis front, center, back, center, front, center, center, front, center, back, center, front, center, back, center. Make a circle with your hips. Round, keeping your shoulders very still. And go the other way. And now working in with just the individual hip, ankle, and knee, we're going to be pulling in with our right leg. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and roll out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we switch sides and roll in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Fantastic. Hopefully we're all getting moving a little bit. So starting from the beginning meeting, we're going to do some plies from a parallel position first. So feet together, and we're going to think about really reaching up through our chest and our arms on each of these plies so that we're lifting our body as we bend our knees. 2 facing forward, and then to the right and to the left. We're going to do that 2 times and then turn into a first position, heels together, toes apart. Same thing with the arms, 2 center, side, and side to begin. And then from there, I'm going to have you move into doing 4 nice deep plies in a second position, really thinking about keeping your knees over your toes. We're going to keep all of those centered this time. So here we go. 6 from parallel. So we lift up, in, up, in. Right. Side. Moving on from here, we're going to do some stroking positions. So starting with your feet parallel, and again, I like to face sideways so that you can see the line of the extension. We want to think of that plie first. Arms just nice and out to the side. I have to step forward a little bit, which means I've got to tip my camera down a little more. Just a bit. I keep running into my wall. So we are starting in that nice plie position. We're going to tendu one leg back. Lift into that arabesque line. And then as that leg is coming in, we're gonna stand up on our standing knee, rebend, place underneath us, and switch to the other side with that tendu, arabesque, standing up as we bring the leg in and transition under. So I really want you to be thinking about keeping that line as long as you can until it's almost impossible to maintain the extension, then you plie under you. So, here we go. One, two, three, five, six, seven, eight, down. Extend back, lift up, and under, okay.
Did you ever want it? Did you want it back? Oh my. Tear me apart. Did you ever find it? All of the pain, so much pride, all into my veins.
All right, fantastic. Let's do our side lunges next. So, thinking about our positions here, I really want you to be, whichever leg is extended, I want you to really feel that pull through your side, like you're reaching as far into space and focusing on that twist through your ribs and your hips each time. So I want you to be thinking about, we're going to do vanilla first, feeling that nice long line, coming together, vanilla the other side, together, reaching up and over, really feel that stretch, up and over, stretch. And then reaching down, feeling that open shoulder, together, and down, together. Here we go.
I'm bleeding.
Together.
I can't stand my way.
Together,
Downward. I've been ashamed all my life.
I need to relocate my little teaching assistant here. All right, there you go. Sorry about that. She is pretty sure she's the star of all my classes now. So moving on from there, she's hopefully trying ATV. Let's move on to some of our cross-stroke based exercises. So we've spent a lot of time talking about that traveling circle, which I'm definitely going to do today, but I want to spend a minute actually working on the positioning of a cross-stroke itself and how to move through that really effectively, because I do feel like it's an area where many skaters can improve, and it's a great place to break it down off the ice, so we're going to do a little bit of that today. So if I'm thinking about establishing a really good cross-stroke, the first thing that I need to do is set a correct edge. So I'm really thinking about a consistent lean through my ankle onto that outside edge. And obviously off the ice, we can't feel that, you know, size circle each time we do it. So I want you to just be thinking about really establishing proper balance over your foot onto a bent leg. And from here, what I'm going to be thinking about is carrying that extension behind me, just like we have on the stroking, and bending both knees through so that I get this like really funky pigeon toe thing going on. Like the transition of this is not the most beautiful part, but that seamless roll through onto that next outside edge so that we can get that understroke and then carry it to the turnout of the next one is the part that makes this beautiful. And then again, I'm going to think about trying to bend both legs under me and slide that foot across and then feel that extension turn out as it comes under. So there's a moment where it is an understroke extension, and then it's going to rotate out and really feel that reach into your position. So at least in my mind, with the exception of when we're holding knees around in a circle with that extension, I'm really trying to think of my cross strokes as kind of low and lower. So I always have that bend to my standing leg. And in that transition where I'm bringing my foot in, I'm trying to emphasize that bend a little bit more to get that kind of momentum of that downward movement into my push so that I can accelerate more aggressively and more evenly throughout it. So I'm weighting that pressure in to really think about that. At least for me, I'm trying to increase that pressure on the front of my boot each time I do a cross stroke. Clearly not wearing skates right now, but we want to feel that nice bend through the ankle while keeping your body very tall and lifted here. So we're going to just walk through a series of cross strokes, and we're going to do them forward, and we're also going to explore them backwards a little bit, which I'll break down in a moment. So starting from a parallel position, we're going to think of that same pushback we did on our stroking. I have to step forward a little bit because I've got a wall there, and I'm going to think about that reaching through bending both knees, sliding my foot across, finding my understroke, then my turn out. And again, thinking about bending both knees, bringing that foot across, stroking through, turning out. So we'll do a series of those first, and then we will do the backwards ones. And I'm going to keep going with the same song because it's 9 minutes long and I can't.
I've been thinking.
Six, ready, seven, eight, think of your stroke back.
We gotta hide.
Bending both knees.
So I've been losing. One day at a time.
Through. Understroke. Transition.
Leading.
Bending both knees through.
Understroke.
Transition out.
I can't stand
through. Under.
Out. In this
hole.
Under.
Out. Bending through. Pushing in. Understroke. Okay, so then to do the same thing moving backwards, I want to think about, I've talked about having my box in various classes many times. So if I'm thinking about a back cross rope, again, the most important thing is establishing an edge in the curve and consistency of that line you're making. But if I'm thinking about, you know, I'm going to be standing on this foot and I'm going to have my other one extended in front of me on that diagonal, I want to be following that diagonal line the whole way through my push. And then I'm going to be moving my leg ever so slightly to that new diagonal after I finish my push. And again, our goal here is to establish that line width turnout on that diagonal, and then trying to bend both knees underneath so that I have pressure into the push onto that new outside edge each time. And for the sake of not having to start like right up next to the camera and working my way back, I'm going to travel sideways in my living room. I think that might be a little bit easier for you guys to see. So we'll see if that works. All right, so here we go. Front, bend both, switch your weight. Bend both, step, twist, and bend both, step, lift, bend, step, and then move under. Okay, so kind of like cross stroke 101. So as you probably noticed as we're doing this, I'm trying to transition my feet as closely as I can. And really, I'm thinking about that moment I put my foot down as slightly to the side of myself on these back ones, so that it's, the motion is sliding behind me onto that plie instead of stepping and doing what I like to call the very funky chicken. So we want to try to have that nice stillness, and with that nice slide push allows you to have that openness and that body carriage that we really think looks elegant on the ice, which is a great thing. So moving on from there, it's time to hold those arabesque circles, my favorite. So we're going to be starting thinking about that outside edge orientation, which means that my same arm as standing leg is going to be in front. We're going to hold and do our quarter circle turns to each side. So here we go. Come in front, make that nice L shape. Hold. Turn to the left shoulder. And turn. Hold. Really reach your foot. Turn. Take a little lift up, place down. Now we start the other side. So I'm going to think of placing that right arm in front. I'm lifting. Hold. Hold. And quarter circle turn towards my right shoulder. And stay. Really feel that long line. Circle. Really lift tall and turn back to the front. A little extra lift and down. Give yourselves a little plie break. Roll your feet out if they're cramping here. Try not to crunch your toes against the floor, makes it harder. So now I'm going to be standing for an inside circle, so I'll be on my left foot, right arm in front, rotating towards the right shoulder. So here we go. Circle, turn to the right, and to the back, really feel that leg pulling long, quarter circle, set for the other side. So now standing on my right, rotating towards my left. And arms. And back. Lifting up. Staying here. And quarter circle to the left. Really feel like you're continuing to stretch as you hold. Facing down, take a little plie, relax. So to go from here, I want to kind of switch up my usual patterning a little bit. So I want to work our fourth position because we've done the Bower 3 exercise, but we haven't really addressed the Bower. And so I want to introduce a fourth position plie to this class for those of you who don't have a background in ballet. If I'm thinking about what my feet are doing, if I'm standing in my first position, my heels are together, my toes are apart, I'm going to overlap my right foot in front of my left at the arch. And then I'm going to slide straight out from there, just about, you know, a little further apart than my hips. You can take it bigger or smaller, but our goal is that alignment is heel to arch and a little bit apart with that good turnout. And we're going to be really thinking about trying to keep our weight centered in between our feet so that each plie is happening directly underneath us. We don't want to be sticking hips out to the back or slumping over to the front, but really feeling that body lift and hold very still as we plie down and driving that knee open over the toe so it's not wrapping in or falling out. And we're going to do some just basic plies here, and then we're going to do a weight transfer, which for those of you who are working on, say, a rumba chakta or a junior moves chakta, this is that motion, but we're going to keep it connected to the floor and think about just extending that weight back and forth, which a bower would be a fourth position with a little bit of, well, I mean, 90% of your weight on that front leg. So we're going to use this position to kind of stretch through that so that as we move into those bower threes, we can think about how that step would happen onto a bower. All right, so just really simply. I'm going to do my right foot in front. 5, 6, 7. We're just going to take a plie. Down, up, nice and slow. Plie, down, up. Plie, up. And one more. Plie, up. Now we're going to plie. So we're going to transfer our weight to the front leg and extend the back. Come down into that plie, switch, so now my weight's in the back foot, plie, switch, and Okay. Switch. Stand up. Bring my foot in. Let's switch to the other side in front. So now I'm going to have my left leg in front of me. I'm going to step out from this position. So heel to arch. Step out. Six. And we're just going to take that nice plie. Plie, we're going to transfer to the front foot. So we're going to set back. Plie down. Switch back. Plie. Front. And plie. Back. And up. And bring that foot into finish.
I see I have a few new messages, so I need to check this. Okay, so to answer the question of how long the class is, about 1 hour. All right, so moving on from here, I want to tackle the bower three. So we just talked about that bower position, that fourth line, that plie underneath us. As I'm thinking about connecting this to my three turns, on the floor, I honestly step a lot closer than I necessarily would with traveling speed on the ice, but I'm still thinking about, I'm putting that foot in, and as I step, I'm stepping a little bit of a bower onto my next push. So I'm thinking about that. Stroke onto my foot, I'm bringing my leg in, turning up and over the ball of my foot onto a straight knee, plieing both, and bringing my foot through onto that next bower. So we're going to try to feel that plie in that fourth position in between each three turn on this pattern today. So here we go. And a couple notes on the three turns really quickly before I move on. I think for the first iteration of this, we're just going to keep the arms faced slightly into our circle, just like, you know, we were trying to do a crossover. And I want you to really think of that extension onto that bent knee, and then it's the motion of standing up on your knee and lifting over the ball of your foot that initiates that turn, just like we would do on the ice for an American Waltz 3 or just a beautiful extended 3 turn generally. So really think about that as we do it. All right, so here we go. If you feel like you're up for the challenge, add an arm to this. So as I step on my left foot, my left arm is going to come up and over my turn. And then I'm going to think of that plie as I step onto my bower, my right arm is going to curve in front of me so that as I'm lifting up to my turn, it's opening over. If you don't feel comfortable moving all the parts at the same time, keep your hands still for balance. It's up to you and what you're comfortable with. It's not required. So here we go. Let's try it with the arm to the light. 5, 6, 7, 8. Stepping on my left. Turn. Plie. Stepping on the right. Turn. Plie.
So now that we've tackled Bowers and Bower threes, let's do John Curry's Mohawk exercise. So for those of you who are not familiar, we do this one pretty much every week, but I'm going to be stepping on my right foot, bringing my left heel to my arch, extending an inside Mohawk, bringing my free leg back into a coupe, then stepping onto my right. Then I'm going to reverse this onto my left. So I'll be stepping on my left, bringing my heel into my arch with the right, extending back through my Mohawk, couping that foot through, and stepping onto my left to prepare to repeat the right side. So here we go. No arms first, we'll just keep them plain. So we're gonna step right, left, so now let's repeat this again. And again, if you would like to add arms, our free arm and free leg are going to work together. So as the leg comes in from the Mohawk, it comes down, lifts up and over, and then coupe, step forward. I take the arms in and over. Right, coupe, forward, right, arm, left, coupe, forward, left, arm, right, coupe, forward, right, left, coupe, forward, coupe. Okay, so moving on from here, we've covered Mohawks, we've covered three turns on the outside edges. I'd like to do some three turns on the inside edges. I have been really thinking a lot in my own teaching and kind of off-ice training lately about accuracy of turns and positions. So I want to work you guys through quite a few iterations of how to turn. Because I do feel like it will help you be more prepared as we are able to get back on the ice to feeling like you understand and have that body awareness a little bit more about things that maybe perhaps we didn't think about previously as much, or maybe we did, but feeling like you have more of that sense of balance underneath yourself and more of that awareness of where you should be standing each time. So we are going to do an inside three exercise. So if I'm starting on my right foot, I'm going to be thinking about my weight being centered over my big toe, and I'm going to get this extension, and my goal is to keep this line consistent the whole way through. So I'm going to be doing the same thing where I lift over my standing leg onto a straight knee and feeling the ball of my foot putting pressure on the ground, but I'm going to try to keep that leg behind me the whole time. So I have kind of an instant check. So take a second, try that. Let's do it on the other foot. So if I'm on my left foot, again, I'm extending my right leg behind me. I would be faced towards my circle. I'm going to think about standing up on my standing knee and lifting over the ball of my foot and then back down into that plie on that standing leg each time. Some of my scanners have found it helpful to do them with an arm coming overhead to help rotate the body around the circle. It's up to you. If that feels more comfortable, by all means, do it. but if it does not, keeping them in the check position is great. what we're going to do is we're going to be taking this inside three turn. This is a very classic Anais pattern, so I'll be stepping onto my right foot. I'm going to get that extension. I'm going to do my inside three, get my plie back, and then I'm going to step towards my left shoulder, forward, crossover. And then I'm going to repeat it to the other side. So left inside edge, three turn, stepping forward on my right, crossing over with my left. So here we go. Step forward, crossing over. Left, two, turn, two, forward, cross over. Right, two, turn, two, forward, cross over. Repeat this one more time. Bring the arms up if you would like on your three turns. Seven. Two. Steps forward. Over. Turn. Two steps forward. Cross over. Right. Two. Turn. Step forward. Over, two, turn, two, step forward, cross over. Okay, so moving on from here, I'm making sure I'm not running myself into the ground for time, but we're doing great. I want to do some waltz threes as an exercise and also get a little bit of a change in body position for you. So for those of you not familiar, the waltz three, we're going to start on an outside three turn, so I'll be on my left. I'm going to do that same beautiful lifted three turn we did on the Bauer threes, but this time as I finish it, I'm going to think of plieing both legs under me, and I'm going to push back into a backwards extension, and then I'm going to step forward, and in this case, I'm going to be bringing my body down and rolling it up. So then same thing on the right side. I'm on my right foot, my left leg is extended. I'm gonna lift into that three turn. I'm gonna plie both legs under me, push back, step forward, and I'm gonna take that nice body roll forward. So I really wanna think about, as I do this, I'm feeling that curve in my spine as I roll up here. And trying to really feel like as I finish my three turn, I'm bringing my leg back in, I feel that plie through both sides so that I'm ready to strike back into that push like a good landing. And then stepping forward into that side nice and strong to come together for my roll forward. All right, so let's give it a shot. Forward. Fantastic. So really trying to feel like you have that body under you, and that change in body position is fantastic. Here we go. We're gonna do some spirals next. So I haven't really worked on these as much with you guys in the last couple weeks, so I feel like we need to address that. And I want you to really be thinking about not just the height of your leg, but the extension of your leg. So you're thinking about establishing that good arabesque line first as we go over. But before we begin that, I want to actually do like a little bit of a strengthening exercise with you guys that looks a little awkward, but is quite helpful to strengthening the muscles through your hip and your back in order to sustain a better position, lift higher. There are many skaters that have the flexibility to put their leg up much higher than they can actually physically sustain holding it. So we're going to kind of work on that to address this. You are welcome to do this holding on to an object nearby, or I'm going to put my hands on the floor personally. It's kind of up to you what feels right to you. Like if you have a fairly low surface, that's ideal. But we're going to start in a kind of just parallel position, and I'm going to think about flat backing forward. I'm going to put my hands on the ground. I'm going to think about plieing both knees under me, and I'm going to lift up one leg and extend it up. And then I'm going to stay on that same foot, plie, reaching up. Each time I'm trying to increase my stretch and my strength, reaching up, and one more plie, reaching up. Holding, and we hear the plie, switch feet. So I'm going to think of now lifting the other foot up, plie, reaching up, getting onto that fully straight knee, plie, reaching up, plie, reaching up, plie, last one. We're going to hold up here, hold, hold, hold. Okay, roll up really slowly. There we go. So we're going to think about now feeling that same strength and those same muscles we just worked with as we do our regular normal spirals. I am going to start on my right leg. It is up to you which one you would like to start with, but we're going to do both. So standing in a parallel position, I want you to lift your arms overhead first. Undo your leg back, get your arabesque, and we're going to spiral over, feeling that nice extension line the whole way through. Keep trying to lift the longer you hold, and keep that leg long as you come down. Close your feet in, and we're going to go to the other side, same thing. I'm turning around because I don't know why. It's not necessary, you don't have to, but I am. So thinking about arms up, lifting through your whole body here, feeling that tendued extension back. I'm gonna lift into my arabesque and spiral over, feeling that lift and stretch the whole way through every joint of my toes, my whole leg, my body, my head, my hands, everything extended and reached. And come back to that tendue, lift tall. Alright, fantastic. Alright, so one of the last things I wanted to kind of do that's brand new with you guys today is working on some rondajons. So one of my favorite spirals to see on the ice are the ones that carry around in the circle. And don't, before you panic, we're not going to do that today, but we are going to start working on the strength of that. I think being able to really sustain a strong standing leg while bringing our working side around is fantastic. I can't tell you how many rondajons I see that get really modern dance, which is great when it's intentional. But I want you to be thinking about really trying to feel that lift, and we're going to be bringing the leg through these positions. We're going to do a few on the floor, and then we're going to try and just a couple inches off and trying to hold that stability to each of these positions without relying on balancing with another object. So we're going to start in a first position. And I'll be working my right leg first. You can pick which side you prefer. Try to lift it off. So we're going to go to the front, lift up, stay. Carry to the side. Make sure you're turning it out.
And a while in front,
to the back,
you want us to go.
Hold.
Don't
stay.
Let go.
Under you. Same thing again.
Let it go.
Lift up.
Hold.
Side. Hold.
No, everybody
else. Five, six, seven, eight.
All
right. Hold.
So show me why you're strong. Nor everybody else. We're alone now. Suddenly I'm happy. It's a sad song. When your friends are gone. When your friends won't come.
Everyone is like bombarding me with messages to do the river pattern. So yes, it is time for river. As a refresher, or if you're brand new to class today, we start on our count one, opening out. Two, we curl down either the whole way into our knees or just with the upper body, up to you and your comfort level. So down on two, push out on three, together on four, and then we're gonna step onto the reverse leg. So out with my left, down, pushing my left leg back and through, out with my right one, down on two, pushing my right leg back, three, four, out with my left, down on two, pushing out with my left, three, and four. Make it big. Not big.
Push, out, 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 push
push. Out, down, push. Out, down, push. Awesome. Okay. That didn't get your heart rate up at the end. I don't know what will. All right, you guys. Thank you so much for joining us today. It's always such a pleasure to have you in this class. We'll be doing it again next Tuesday. As a reminder, on Thursday at 1:30, we're doing the Off-Ice Choreo Lab featuring Isaac Lindy this week. You can join us on Zoom or on Instagram Live. We'd be delighted to have you. And thank you again to everyone who's donated for your continued support to Ice Theater of New York. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.